guys, so today I'm going to make the compound slider first. I didn't use any bowl right here and spindle right here, so I just keep and everything finished with the compound slider. Then it's time I made all this one. But this is the milling attachment, so that means I can keep right here and moving around. So this is I have done the last video, but this is not easy to make it because my small homemade lathe working is not good. It's working good exactly the small diameters, but this is a big diameter, so not easy to milling. So here is the big piece. Here is the big piece. So this is a huge piece. So this is a huge piece. So this piece, not the same the cross slider. The cross slider, it is a many pieces, metal, combined together, but right here I use only one piece. But you can see here is a big piece. Big piece. Here is the big piece. I got it from a shop. The first video and the first cross slider, I made many pieces joined together, but right here it's only one. So this is it's only 120 millimeters, and then length 220 millimeters. So that means this is really not easy to make it because I will use my grind angle cut in this shape and both side, and then I need, so my problem is I have to make the hole right here. I don't know how can I make this. Perhaps I will cut the slide here, make a small hole right here. So let's see how do I make this. But I don't know how many hours or how many days, because all this I don't have any millings. I have only, you know, grinding cold cut do here. Okay, let's so it's time to work. It's a really hard work because this is a really big piece. So I will cut on this shape here and right here too. So I didn't share how I make this one, but it's not easy. I just pack everything, press here, and I make a straight line, and then I will use my slush cut cutting this one shape here. Okay, just do the straight line right here, but this straight line can be worked with other side right here. So I already setting this. I need this is straight in the line there. I hope it's work. So this one I have carefully, if I cut this one exactly, just moving very little, and this one too very little. So what happened next for me? So I need to scrape the slush in this side. So otherwise, I just make step by step and carefully, because after I cut looks very easy, but however, I need everything in the line first. So already I just hang the slush cut here. So now, I'm sorry I didn't share how I make this, but I think you can understand what happened this, because I'm not easy, because this is a really the big plate I can do. So now it's time I cut it. I have to be carefully about this one, is I have very little mistake about 2 or 3 millimeters, not 2 or 3, just 0.1, 0.2 millimeters. Maybe I can do, but this is really hard for scraping out here. See this, the scraping here. So this is a scraping, so I need to scrape here. So the first time I just made the slush first, and both sides here. So finally, when I find out the 16 millimeters, so each time I cut the sideway right here. So now it's time to work. Okay, so now I have done right here. So the one side ready. So this is okay, but my next step, other side, have to be carefully about this is at the angle or not, whatever I can see. Because this is a slush cut, actually straight already, but what happened, the problem is, this is moving up and down, so this way and this way must be not exactly the same size, but the here smaller and this bigger. So let's see, I move up. How the shape here. So I'm happy, but let's see how I cut this one first. So my slush cut one side will finish, so I will continue on this side, and after I finish here, I will cut on this shape here. So this shape easy, but this is the problem. What I can see, the slush cut here is first one okay, but second one must be exactly or in the straight line. It's just moving only 1 millimeters, maybe nothing work. So that is a problem. So I'm happy, because that means I have cut like that. It's a big piece and heavy too. So now I'm going to the next step here. So I will slush in this side. This side I already finished. So now I'm going to this. So I try do again and again many times to find out the line here and the line here, straight cut everything I want 100% and context and I just slice cut on top here. So this is what I want. So now each time I do start slash cut and this side. So on this side, I'm not use the other piece cover here because I use a clamp lock here already. And below is how this one connecting because I use other plate and then I welds stuck on this slash. Then I just put on it and this one I use for locking, you know, the metal move down or up, and one more below this. It's worked very good when I start this one first.
How is cutting right now?
I have to use their helmet because it protects my face and my arm because these I don't have to cover because this is a really bigger than the first one here. It's wet right now. I welding both sides here, and I do the same thing as the below right here. So now it's time to cut one more size. So now it started. I have done two slides already, so now it's time. So now it's finished already. I'm so happy. My slider angle cut could be work. I never believed like that. So I never have any idea how do I make this. But right now, I have done with this and really happy. Just at the end of time, I just scraping this slider, and then I think it's good. You can see how I cut the slush. So now you can see I have the slider for my compound slider. So that means this is really good. I never know my grind angle cut could be work like that. So I always use my grind angle just cut only the flat and straight one. So now it's worked very good. That's really helping me a lot. You see this, the slush cut right here. So it's nice and straight here. You can see how. So I'm happy with this because the first time I never thought I can make this one. Okay, so this is, I will upload my next video, my compound slider. So now I have done this, I just share you how I use the grind angle cut do this.